Let's get into answers. And the first thing we will do is specify the geometric parameters appearing in the mathematical model that we want to solve, which, as we saw, was based on minimization of total potential energy. To see what are the geometric parameters that we need to specify, I'll go back to a slide from the pre-analysis. And so here, looking at the slide, I see that I need to specify the midlines of the three truss members and specify the length, this length here, and also the cross-sectional area. So let me do that. I'll go into the search area and search for workbench, and I'll start workbench 18.1. 18.1 being the version that I'm using. It's among the latest versions. And once the project page comes up under Analysis Systems, you need to scroll down and select Static Structural and drag it into the project page. And in the process, we have given answers, an important clue about what is the mathematical model we want to solve. More on that later. So you can think of these analysis systems as giving you access to solvers that will solve mathematical models that appear commonly in engineering. So let's rename the project. I will call it Truss Tutorial. Enter. And we'll be going down this list. I will come back to engineering data later. I'll start with geometry, and I'll right-click on geometry. And you can see there are two geometry engines. There's Space Claim, which is the new geometry engine and the default, and there's Design Modeler, which is the older geometry engine. I hear people raving about Space Claim, so I want to learn it. I'm not there yet, so I'll retreat to Design Modeler. And in Design Modeler, I'll select units and specify it to centimeters, since our lengths are given in centimeters, and that'll resize the palette to centimeters. And go highlight XY plane, since I'll do the sketch on the XY plane. I'll say look at plane. I'll go into the sketching mode, sketching tab, highlight line, and I will draw a line and make sure I see the, hover around the origin until you see the P. If you don't see the P, you have to go under constraints and go down all the way to auto constraints and make sure these are turned on. In an earlier version, these were turned off by default, and it gave us a lot of headache and, pulling of hair, and the result is often not pretty. So I'll say draw line, make sure I get the P. I'll draw the line to the right. The H means it's horizontal, which also I want. And the C means that endpoint is coincident with the horizontal axis, which I want. I'll release that, okay? The second line, start off with the point that was created. So make sure you get the P. Make sure you get the V for vertical. And then the third line is from this P to that P. And let's dimension them, okay? And if I go back to the problem specification, I see that the length is 45 centimeters, so let me dimension that. So I'll say dimension, I'll put in a dimension here and a dimension here. It'll let you do that if you go into the dimensions toolbar. And so that's 45, and that's 45. Okay, and I can say zoom to fit. I can also click on Z. I can zoom in and out using the middle mouse wheel. Okay, now if I go into modeling, I still don't have a part. That's because you do a sketch and then you create the part from the sketch. In 3D, you might be creating an area and extruding it to create the part. So there, the sketch is 2D, and the part is 3D. Here in both are lines, the sketch as well as the body, which is can be a little bit confusing. Okay, so let's create the part or the body. I'll go to concept, lines from sketches, and I'll highlight any part of the sketch. I can click on any part of the sketch and say apply and generate. And now I see that I have a body which Ansys calls line body. If I turn off the sketch, I see the line body consists of the midlines of the three truss members. And this is what is passed forth into the solver. So that looks right. And next we will specify the cross-sectional area. But before that, let's save the project. So I will go back to the project page and I'll say File, Save, and go to a convenient folder. And call it something suitable. I will call it Truss and I'll say Save. And if you go to the folder in which you saved it, you'll see that there's truss.wbpj and also an associated folder, truss underscore files. You need this as well as this to recreate the project. I've seen students forgetting to, save this to a flash drive. In which case you lose your work and it's can be very frustrating. So make sure you have that and before you, exit the logout of the computer, make sure you've saved those to a flash drive or a network drive, and so on, especially if you're in a public computer lab. And the backup will go away when I exit Ansys. Next, let's specify the cross-sectional area of the truss members.